Independence would not be a trial separation. It would be a painful divorce. And as Prime Minister, I have to tell you what that would mean. It would mean we no longer share the same currency. It would mean the armed forces we've built up together over centuries being split up forever. It would mean our pension funds being sliced up at some cost. It would mean the borders we have would become international and may no longer be so easily crossed. It would mean the automatic support that you currently get from British embassies when you're travelling around the world, that would come to an end. It would mean over half of Scottish mortgages suddenly, from one day to the next, being provided by banks in a foreign country. It would mean that interest rates in Scotland are no longer set by the Bank of England with all the stability and security that promises. And it would mean for any banks that remain in Scotland, if they ever got into trouble, it would be Scottish taxpayers and Scottish taxpayers alone that would bear the costs. It would mean that we no longer pool resources across the whole of our United Kingdom to pay for institutions like our National Health Service or our welfare system. This is not guesswork. There are no question marks, no maybe this or maybe that. The nationalists want to break up UK funding on pensions, the UK funding on healthcare, the UK funding and comprehensive protection on national security. These are the facts. This is what would happen, an end to the things that we share together. And the people of Scotland must know these facts before they make this once and for all decision. Now, to warn of the consequences is not to scaremonger. It's like warning a friend about a decision that they might take that will affect the rest of their lives and the lives of their children. I say all this because I don't want the people of Scotland to be sold a dream that disappears.